Hello, my dear students. This is Saloni Jain. Welcome to my channel, Learn Programming with Saloni. In our previous video, we have learned mark sheet, how to make a mark sheet. See, this is a mark sheet. Okay. If you have not watched my video, last video, I will provide you the link in the description box of my previous video. Just go through that video and then watch this video again. Okay, so in this video I will tell you how to make report card like this. See, this is a report card. Okay, so if you want to, you have already made the mark sheet and now you want to create a report card, and you just type the row number and automatically it will generate the marks of a particular report card of a particular row number, and as well as the graph chart. Okay, I will show you how to make a graph chart also. Okay, so I just remove all things, just make a report card format. Just clear all these cells, and wherever you want to type, just highlight that. Okay, type the school name, city, mark sheet of, I have taken mark sheet of 12th class, you can take any name, father's name, date of birth, you can either whatever information you want, set accordingly. Okay, so I have taken total marks, theory, and as a practical, and passing marks, and practical marks, passing marks. Okay, so automatically it generate here, automatically this marks, theory marks, practical marks, when I enter this roll number here and change the roll number, and it will generate automatically, change the name and all, every information, right? Like this, if I take a roll number 8, it automatically change the name. But here the formula is not given, that's why it is not showing here. Okay, so let's start. Here is a formula VLOOKUP. It is very interesting formula. How can you do this? How can you work on it? You just go to the previous sheet, that is a mark sheet, and set the numbers here, 1, 2, and give each column, just select it and just click on it, sorry, just a minute, just drag it like this. So I have given numbers to each column, start from 1 and last is 23 for the grade. Okay, now come on the report card. So we learn how to use a VLOOKUP formula. It's a very easy formula. I just remove this here, from here also. Okay, I just remove this one, okay. And this one also, and this one also. Okay, so you just type VLOOKUP. I just make it more zoom. Okay, oh yeah, now it is visible to you. See, VLOOKUP. Okay, select the cell of row number, okay, and make it absolute, make it fixed by pressing F4 key. Okay, comma, I have already given the range as well. You have to define range as well of this particular sheet. So my range name is 2. Okay, so I just select as 2. Okay, comma, I just want my name is on the second. Okay, so just click on second and just press, it will automatically comes the name. Okay, I just change the name 101. It will show you the, see, 101, whose roll number is 1011. Okay, so name is 2. I just type 100 roll number because I'm starting from 100, so name 1. Okay, and just drag on it, drag it, and change the number here, 3. So father name, copy the formula like this and paste it, and just change the number on 4. Okay, it is not showing the date of birth because its format is general. You just select it and just select the date format, short date. Okay, clear? Yeah. Next one is marks. Okay, Now Hindi marks. Okay, you just check where the Hindi mark. It is a 10. Okay, you just copy the formula again from here. Just copy it and put here marks. Okay, and it is merged. Just unmerge and change this. It is 10. Okay, you need to only change the this. 10. Just a minute. Let me check. 10 is 65. It is 10. Just a minute. Okay. I just change again the formula. Equal. We look up. Okay. First, I just set the formula. Select the row number cell and make it fixed. F4. Commas 2 is my range and it's 10 number. Okay. Just change the format. I just take the number or number format. Okay, it will come. Now next one is English. Okay. See English, maths, chemistry. I just change the number. Okay, I just copy it. Now look at the English cell. It is, I think, 11. Just change it here, 11. It will automatically come. 11, one mark only. Okay, next one is for physics. So physics cell is, I think, 5. Okay, so change it to 5. Right, 5. Okay, next one is chemistry. Chemistry is 7. Just change it to 7. Okay, 7. And next one is maths. Maths is 55. It's 9. Okay, 9 number. Its number is 9. I'm just change that 9 number. Okay, now you have the practical marks of chemistry, physics and chemistry. Okay, so these are the physics. Physics, this is a 5 and this will be the 6. Just copy paste here. Okay, and just type here 6. Okay, again copy paste 7 and it will be 8. I think if I have put next column, no? Right, so now you want to find out the total. You just type some formula and select these two cells and enter, and just click on here. It will show you the obtain marks. Obtain marks, I have used the formula obtain marks again. Total marks, I just typed it. Passing marks, whatever you passing marks you want, you can use the formula here, sum, and select this range for the passing marks. Just a minute. Yes, select this. This is the passing marks. Okay, so 155. So what is the percentage? How can you calculate the percentage? Just click on this cell divided by total marks. Okay. See, percentage will, you will get the percentage. Okay, automatically it will show you the this 22 mark sheet in 22. These are things. Okay, but it is not showing all. You can just reduce the cell. If you don't want to show, you can increase this like this, and you can like this, grade in this, this and grade is E. Okay. So I just copy it. Okay. So and now I want to show the graph as well. You just select this subject and the total marks. So select it, insert, go to insert and recommended this column chart. Okay, just select the column chart and okay, Select the first one. It will show you the chart. Just place here. Just place here like this. Okay. Now these are the subject. You can give the title as well. You can add chart element. You can use this. And just click on here chart title. It is a mark sheet. Just type it. Mark. Okay. And what is the x-axis and y-axis? You just select the axis title, horizontal. Okay. And you just chart titles, you have given it already. Axis title, horizontal, you just type here subjects. Subjects. In capital letter, you just write capital letter subjects. You can increase the size of the phone from the home tab. Just increase the size, make it bold. Okay. And the y-axis. Select it, format, go to format and design. Select the y-axis. Okay, here type the marks. So select it and type marks. Okay, and just select it and increase the size so that it is visible to you all. See. Just a minute. M capital R. And make it bold. Select it. Go to home tab. Make it bold. Okay. Now it is showing the single color. If you want key, you want key color will different color for each subject. You just select one particular. Just click on the control button. And control button again. And select the one single cell. Like this, see, like don't select the rules, just select this. Okay, like this. Now okay, just select this color, just select the change you want. Now it is selected. If you select whole cell, it will select all the sheet. Just select it and again select it. Okay, I just show you again. Just select the chart, select the cell. Again press the control key and select one particular cell like this. Again, yes. Now it is selected. Now change the color. Go to the fill color and select suppose red color. I just select here. Select the yellow color. Okay, I just select this cell. I just take it green color. Okay, and just select this bar. I just click blue color, and just select this. I select more color. So it looks nice. Now I just change the roll number. If I change the roll number 106, suppose. So automatically it changes the whole sheet, see, and you can create a PDF file by clicking on file, save as option, save as, browse, and wherever you want to save, suppose on desktop, on any other drive, just select the desktop and select the PDF, okay, and click on the save, okay. So mark sheet new, it will show you this particular sheet and you can send to your particular roll number. Okay, so in this way it will generate a PDF as well. It will show you on the I will show you on the desktop. There is a mark sheet, select the mark sheet. See. So this one is a particular, you can save the name of the roll number and send it to a particular roll number as well. Okay, now these days are the we have the study online, so it is very useful, guys. Please use this mark sheet, right? See, it will show just a minute. Okay, one thing, go to the page break and show full page like this, and again select save as, browse, again select the PDF till stop, save it, yes, okay. Now, you just go to the desktop, open it, it will show you the, see, a particular roll number PDF, 106, like this, and you can send it. I hope you like my video, and I hope it is very useful to you. I have told you that because a graph, a picture is 100 words, isn't it? So whenever you change the roll number, just you have to change the roll number, automatically new graph, new marks, new name, automatically generated. And one by one, you just generate the PDF files and send it to. Okay, you can send mail and all. So in this way, you can create the right use of Excel sheet. How to make mark sheet, then report card, and show the this graph as well. So guys, that's all for the videos, and I will tell you in the next video so many tips and tricks of Excel, which is very useful. Okay, and if you like my video, please do share my video, please subscribe my channel, and press the bell icon for my new upcoming updates. Okay, I'm teaching here three packages, like Scratch is a language, Python language, and as well as Excel. So thank you guys for watching my video.